I now invite the Distinguished International Organization for the Elimination of All Forms of Racial Discrimination, please.
Thank you, Mr. President. Earlier this year, a major decision was taken by UN member states to heavily cut the budget of the UN. E. Ford and Geneva International Center for Justice would like to express our deep concern with this decision as it adversely affects the functioning of the Human Rights Council, its human rights bodies and mechanisms, and in turn humanitarian and climate disasters and the most vulnerable who deserve this council's attention. It is deeply worrying that this decision was taken after acknowledging that the total workload of this council more than doubled and is likely to increase considering the current and projected state of human rights situations across the globe. Such budget cuts with reduced allocated time equate to less efficiency, less data, and a reduction of expertise. Mr. President, how are we expected to promote and protect human rights with a reduced budget and increased workload? We are also very much concerned that these cuts will reduce civil society space in the UN by way of indirect factors that may not be realized until it is too late. On this issue, we note that while this Council's President has continuously warned against acts of intimidation, personal attacks, and other behavior of that nature, we regrettably inform that most recently there have been such incidents by members of this Council against representatives of non-government organizations. It is also with deep regret to note that there appears to be a selective attitude in addressing reprisals against NGOs. In conclusion, we reiterate the words of Danish lawyer Morten Kjerum, quote, "The civil society organizations are the eyes, the ears, and the voice for protecting and promoting human rights. The importance of NGOs can therefore not be overstated."